Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Wang. Here is the question. Prove that for any positive integer, we have the following three results. The first result, n to the power of 3 minus n is divisible by 3. The second result is n to the power of 5 minus n is divisible by 5. And the last result is n to the power of 7 minus n is divisible by 7. It looks that there's a pattern for this kind of question. Here, 3, 5, 7 are odd numbers. Is that always true? If we change, for example, 7 to 9, here's 9. That means n to the power of 9 minus n is divisible by 7, by 9. N to the power of 11 minus n is divisible by 11. We're not sure. If there's enough interest in this kind of question from my audience, I will continue to discuss this kind of question next time. By the way, we can relax this condition. N is not necessary to be a positive integer. Any integer, these three results are true. Let's prove the first result by factoring. We have n to the power of 3 minus n equals n times n squared minus 1 equals n times n minus 1, n plus 1. These three numbers are consecutive integers. Therefore, n to the power of 3 minus n is divisible by 3. At least one of these numbers is divisible by 3 because they are consecutive. For the second result, we can factor x to the power of 5 minus n. Continue to factor this result. Then we have n to the power of 5 minus n equals n times n minus 1 times n plus 1 times n squared plus 1. Let's consider the ones digit of n. In number theory, we use this kind of notation. This is called congruent. This is called modulo. The last digit, or we call the ones digit of n, can be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, until 9. We consider this last digits first. Later on, we will consider other situations. We use the product of the first three numbers here. If the ones digit is 0, we can replace n by 0. Therefore, the product is 0. 0 is divisible by 5. If n, the last digit is 1, n minus 1, the last digit is 0. Therefore, the whole thing is divisible by 5. If it is 4, n plus 1 is 5. So 5 is divisible by 5. If it is 6, 6 minus 1 is 5. I mean here, it's the last digit. It's divisible by 5. 9 plus 1 is 10. The last digit is 0. Therefore, the whole thing is divisible by 5. We consider other situations. If the ones digits are 0, 2, 3, 7, 8, we use this factor. If it is 2, 2 squared is 4. 4 plus 1 is 5. 5 is divisible by 5. If the last digit is 3, 3 squared is 9. 9 plus 1 is 10. 10 is divisible by 5. The remainder is 0. 7. 7 squared is 49. 9 plus 1 is 10. 10 is divisible by 5. N equals 8. 8 times 8, 64. 64 plus 1 is 65, which is divisible by 5. We have done all possibilities of the last digit. Therefore, n to the power of 5 minus n is divisible by 5. The last situation, n to the power of 7 minus n. By factoring and simplification, we have this result. It's a similar idea. We consider the remainder of n divided by 7. All possible remainders are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Let's consider remainders of 0, 1, 3 first. Later on, we consider other possible remainders. We consider the product of the first three numbers. If the remainder of n is 0, we replace n by 0. Therefore, the product is divisible by 7. If we replace the remainder of n by 1, n minus 1, the remainder is 0. Therefore, the product of the three numbers is divisible by 7. If the remainder is 6, 6 plus 1 is 7. 7 is divisible by 7. Therefore, for these three situations, n to the power of 7 minus n is divisible by 7. If the remainder of n divided by 7 is 2. 2 squared is 4. 2 is 2 here and 1. The sum of these three numbers is 7. 7 is divisible by 7. Therefore, when the remainder divided by 7 is 2, n to the power minus 7, n to the power of 7, minus n is divisible by 7. When the remainder is 4, if divided by 7, we have the remainder of n squared plus n plus 1 equals 16 plus 4 plus 1, which is 21. 21 is divisible by 7. Therefore, when the remainder of n divided by 7 is 4, n to the power of 7 minus n is divisible by 7. If the remainder of n divided by 7 is 3, we use this factor. N squared minus n minus 1 has remainder 9, because 3 squared is 9, minus n, that's 3, plus 1, which is 7. 7 is divisible by 7. Therefore, n to the power of 7 minus n is divisible by 7 if the remainder of n is 3 divided by 7. If the remainder of n divided by 7 is 5, we use this factor again here. The remainder of n squared minus n plus 1 equals 5 squared, which is 25, minus 5 plus 1. Simplify this part, we have 21. 21 is divisible by 7. Therefore, n to the power of 7 minus n is divisible by 7 if the remainder of n divided by 7 is 5. Therefore, n to the power of 7 minus n is divisible by 7. We have done all the proofs. That's all. Thanks for watching and see you next time.